Okay, we are so excited for this. It's Monday. You know that we always talk to our friends at the Metro Park Zoo to see what they have going on. And now we can enjoy the bare necessities.
Yeah, it was a great thing. They had the ribbon cutting on Friday. The work is finally done. Susie's Bear Hollow is open.
Yay!
Animal curator Travis Vineyard joining us live from the zoo in today's Metro Parks Monday. The grand tour. Show us all around.
Yeah, good morning. Thanks for visiting us. We are just so happy and so very thankful that we're finally open here. So grateful to be sharing this with our visitors. Susie's Bear Hollow. Now, these exhibits we've been actively working on for over a year, and these spaces are very specifically tailored to both Andean bears and sloth bears. Now, Andean bears are a species that is native to South America. And this sloth bear that you're seeing in front of you, they range in India primarily and the surrounding countries around India. So these are both very dynamic species.
Wow, what do they eat?
Well, that's an interesting question. So the sloth bear that you see in front of you, these bears are insectivores. They eat an insectivore diet. And so they're very, very interesting in the bear world. But to contrast that with Andean bears are vegetable eaters. So they eat a lot of plant material.
So show us the layout
there.
It looks like it's enclosed and you got glass. So you're able to walk up and see the bears pretty close.
Yeah. Yeah, this is a huge improvement from what was here. So at minimally, you know, this space is three times larger than it was previously. And again, these spaces are designed around the natural history of these species. And one of the most dramatic things that you'll notice is all of the climbing opportunities. And one of the really neatest things about this space is the public immersion into this space. And we're looking at this climbing feature here. This is about an 18-foot tall climbing structure for kids. And they can mirror what the bears are doing on the outside exhibits. They can get up and really experience the height that the bears do in these new spaces.
That's so neat for kids to experience something like that too, and watch, kind of observe how like these sloth bears are climbing, and then they get to emulate the same thing. And then peek out at the bears as well when they reach a certain height.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, our goal is to always, you know, connect people with wildlife, and it starts with young people. And, you know, we want to create memories, and we want that to translate into conservation action, you know, however big or small. And coming here to visit the zoo, check out our very, very impressive graphics here that we have. Obviously see the bears and learn from the bears. And obviously, you know, we can check out our website, you know, Future for Wildlife, and talk about and learn from the conservation programs that we participate in. Andean Bear Conservation Alliance is one of the premier programs that we support and back. But you know, just coming here to witness these bears and having them observe natural behaviors is a learning experience in its own.
Well, and I understand there's a separate little viewing area there too that allows for people to see up close maybe some animal care that they receive. So it's something kind of like peeking into a window that ordinarily we never would be able to see.
Yeah, that's right. You know, we can bring our visitors into the husbandry world that we perform, and we can demonstrate some husbandry training. It could be either being voluntarily injections for vaccines, could be mouth exams for preventive dentistry, presenting your feet to get a manicure every once in a while.
Wow.
All of those things, all things go into play for caring for these species.
How neat.
Hey, Travis, we got to go, but who's Susie?
Who's Susie? Well, she's a beloved supporter of the Cleveland Metro Park Zoo.
Okay.
Oh,
all right.
That's
well,
so
good.
Nice.
Glad she gets her name on that.
In her honor. Yeah. Right. Wow.
But Travis, thanks so much live from the Cleveland Metro Park Zoo. Don't forget, by the way, the Asian Lantern Festival extended through September 16th. They got that wild ride on September 17th. That's where you can bike through.
Right.
So that's pretty cool. You have to bring your bikes to that.
And don't forget the zip line, too. That's on my bucket list. I want to do that. Yeah.